Triage Project is an effort by the Michigan Geological Survey to ensure the quality of our state's water well database. This is a grant-funded project facilitated by Western Michigan University's Department of Geological and Environmental Sciences and directed in part by the Michigan Department of Great Lakes and Energy, working closely with the Michigan PFAS Action Response Team. The Triage Project has three primary objectives: to validate the existing water well database containing over 600,000 well logs, with special attention to details affecting the accuracy of maps and models regarding groundwater contamination; to build upon the existing database by recovering, validating, and digitizing historic well logs, as well as digitizing the logs of recently drilled water wells; and to provide a range of services and products related to water well data, primarily response-based expedited data validation and a suite of hydrogeologic maps and models. This effort is primarily in response to PFAS contamination concerns. The state of Michigan is currently leading the nation in PFAS research and legislation, with the most strict regulations on allowable concentrations for consumption. This is because PFAS, or perfluorinated alkyl substances, are harmful to human health and environment in just low concentrations, specifically on the order of parts per trillion. This ratio is comparable to a single drop of water in an Olympic-sized swimming pool. Overconsumption of PFAS can lead to liver damage, thyroid disease, decreased fertility, cancer, or other adverse health effects. There are over 6,000 varieties of PFAS, characterized by their atomic structure. These chemicals have both hydrophilic and hydrophobic properties, meaning they attract water on one end of their atomic structure and repel water on the opposite end, making them successful barriers to heat, oil, grease, and water. They have been used for their versatility in a wide variety of industrial processes and applications such as fireproofing or firefighting, leather tanning, and production of many non-stick and water-resistant products. PFAS is extremely difficult to remediate in that it has a low threshold for toxicity, but also in that it is so strongly bonded that most remediation techniques are ineffective, requiring protracted and costly solutions. Furthermore, once PFAS enters the system, it is highly mobile. It is an emergent contaminant that most all waste treatment facilities do not treat for. When industries send their waste, the PFAS is left intact and is released in effluent water to nearby surface water bodies and as a solid to farmlands in the form of fertilizers, both perpetuating the cycle and spreading PFAS, making it a challenge to determine its source and extent. This highlights the importance of having an accurate water well database. It was found in response to early PFAS contamination concerns that much of the water well database had errored well locations and other fields directly pertinent to the accuracy of groundwater maps and models. Review of water well data for a number of Michigan counties prioritized by their level of concern and population showed an average error of 38%, a significant margin for well location. When considering all log fields essential to the construction of reliable models in review of historic data, it was found that nearly all logs required correction in at least one essential field. The responsibility of building this database was previously shared by multiple entities, making it difficult to perform quality assurance, now performed by the Michigan Geological Survey. The project first began in 2019 by validating purely the location of existing water well data. Over time, other phases have been added to the project after seeing continued success, such as entry of recently drilled well logs and review and entry of historical data. Like many organizations, MGS had to make adjustments with the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic, which was met with the transitioning of the project from in-office to predominantly remote, granting the unforeseen opportunity for team expansion. Upon validation of a substantial portion of the data set, the mapping phase of the project was launched to build high-quality, reliable hydrogeologic maps. Most recently, the education and outreach phase was added, allowing the triage team to deliver effective learning and training content. Over the last 2 years, the triage project has grown, now including a number of phases which utilize a variety of skill sets and employ a range of professionals and semi-professionals. There are additionally some seasonal opportunities for fieldwork related to drilling, core recovery, and remote sensing. Overall, the skill sets of our team members fall into two categories: problem solving and collaboration. The everyday workflow of our staff is an exercise of background knowledge and practice of several technical tools and procedures. It is beneficial to have some experience with GIS software, public speaking, and hydrogeology field methods. It is crucial in remote work environments to maintain direct and regular communication, make inquiries where needed, and to help other staff where possible. Many of our tasks are highly independent and require good time management and focus. Much of what we do surrounds the idea of taking a water well log completed by a driller and making it something useful to us as hydrogeologists. In addition to digitizing a large volume of data, this process can present some unique challenges in interpreting the listed geology, identifying and interpolating locations described only by the public land survey, shear legibility, and more. For pre-existing data in well logic, well locations are validated with a 200-foot accuracy radius. This often requires correction when coordinates were not collected on-site during drilling or when a record was hastily entered in the past. The average errored well location is corrected by a distance of approximately 850 feet, but some records have been found to be placed in incorrect townships or wrong counties entirely, putting them miles away from actuality. Because there is a range in the difficulty level and degree of error at each log, an additional challenge posed to our staff is in maximizing productivity while maintaining accuracy, which has seen a continual increase as the project has grown and the workflow has developed. With newly validated and bolstered datasets, MGS is able to provide a number of reliable map products such as hydrogeologic cross-sections, groundwater flow maps, and other visual aids in determining the extent of and predicting transport of groundwater contaminants. MGS Education and Outreach by the Triage Project focuses on informing the public, those interested in environmental sciences and hydrogeology, and our team of key concepts and topics, critical background, and technical practices and skills related to Michigan groundwater resources. In addition to recorded educational content and everyday practice, Triage team members are presented with a number of seasonal fieldwork opportunities on special projects collaborating with the Michigan Geological Repository for Research and Education, the U.S. Geological Survey, and other research groups at Western Michigan University, allowing our team to gain valuable experience in field techniques pertaining to drill core recovery and analysis, water well drilling methods and practices, and remote sensing. The Triage Project employs hydrogeologists and geologists with concentrated backgrounds and interest in PFAS transport, Michigan geology, and contaminant remediation, and GIS specialists and environmental scientists specifically working with ArcMap, ArcPro, and remote sensing software. However, the majority of the team are actually active students pursuing degrees in related fields and acquiring a foundation for their professional careers. If you're interested in joining the Triage Project or would like to inquire about any of our services, see the job postings and contact information in the video description below. Thanks for watching!